Good afternoon. Myself Santosh Bharti. In previous lecture, I discussed about the pulse modulation. Pulse modulation, basically the digital pulse modulation. In digital pulse modulation, so many type of the modulation, right? The PCM pulse code modulation, differential pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation. In previous lecture, now pulse code modulation and differential pulse code modulation has described or discussed. Now I am going to discuss about the delta modulation. There are so many drawbacks of the PCM system. In PCM system, every sample are represented by n bit. When we use the DPCM, differential pulse code modulation, now these redundancies reduces by the DPCM. What is the redundancy? In PCM system means some samples, when we doing the sampling theorem, try the sampling now, it convert continuous time signal into the sample form, a discrete form. Maybe the more than one sample continuously representing the same binary information. Yeah? And each binary information is transmitted over the channel. Now it will occupy the whole channel bandwidth, because the bandwidth is half of the bitrate. If more number of bits are transmitted, the bitrate is high. Bitrate is high means bandwidth, occupied bandwidth is high. So then this number of bits are reduces by reducing the redundancy. Means if more than one sample contains same information, then only one sample is transmitted over the channel. So this can be done by using the DPCM system. So DPCM work on the based on the prediction, means it predicts the present value with the past value, and their difference is quantized. Yeah? If both samples are same, now their difference is zero. Their difference is zero means now there is no any bits are required to repeat that sample. Yeah? If the sampled value not exactly same, the difference is very minimum value. That very minimum value is quantized either one level or two level. If it is quantized two level or one level, it requires only one bit to repeat that sample. Yeah? So by this way now, repeat. Basically in PCM system, if you are using audio signal of 4 kHz, the sampling rate or bit rate require 64 kbps. While for the same information, when you apply the DPCM system, now the bit rate is reduces by half. Half is 64 kb in PCM and 32 kbps in the DPCM system. And DPCM also reduces the quantization error because it quantizes very low value of the signal. Right? And in delta modulation, in PCM system basically every sample is denoted by n bit, but in delta modulation every sample is denoted by only single bit. So delta modulation is also known as one bit version of DPCM. Yeah? If you are comparing with the block diagram of DPCM, if you replace prediction block with the delay element, now DPCM work as a delta modulator. Right? So definition of delta modulation. Delta modulation is a technique which provide a staircase approximation to an oversampled version of the message signal XT as shown in figure A. In the figure you can see here, actually this is the continuous time signal, suppose this is the XT and this is the staircase signal. Yeah? If XT is greater than or equals to X capt means this is the staircase signal. If XT is greater than X cap T, in the previous samples, it add plus delta step size. That is, it denoted as a bit 1. Now you can see here, it reduces by bit 1, denoted by bit 0. If XT is less than X cap T, now it denoted by minus delta or transmitted bit 0. You can see here, now it reduces one step size
with the previous samples divided by bit 0. Again, reduces 1, equal to bit 0. Again, add 1 step size, bit 1. Reduces 1, 0. Add 1, 1. Add 1, bit 1. Add 1, transmitted bit 1. Add 1, transmitted bit 1. Add 1, transmitted bit 1. Reduces 1 step size, transmitted bit 0. Again, add 1. Reduce, subtract 0. Again, subtract 0. Subtract 0. Subtract 0. Subtract 0. By this way, now every sample is denoted by only single bit. Yeah? If every sample is denoted by only single bit, means bit rate is reduces. If bit rate is reduces, now the bandwidth is half of the bit rate. Ultimately, bandwidth is also reduces in the delta modulation compared to PCM system. Right? PCM system. A PCM system, it transmits all the bits which are used to code sample as signaling rate and transmission channel bandwidth is quite large. While to overcome this problem, now delta modulation is used, because in delta modulation, individual sample is only defined or represented by single bit. If the difference of actual signal with the staircase signal is positive, it adds one step size, denoted by bit 1. If actual signal minus staircase signal is less than, means actual signal minus staircase signal is negative, now it subtract one step size and denoted by bit 0. So by this way, now bit rate is reduces. Ultimately, now you can see here from this block diagram, this is the oversample. Oversample means in delta modulation, suppose fs delta is the sampling frequency for the delta modulation. This is equals to 3 or 4 times of fs for PCM. What sampling frequency you are using in the PCM system? That is the 3 to 4 times larger sampling frequency used in the delta modulation. That's why it is called oversampling. Yeah? Now, TS delta, sampling interval for the delta modulation, this is equals to 1 by FS delta, or this is equals to 1 upon 3 or 4 times of the 2 times of FM. Or this is equals to either 1 by 6 FM or 1 by 8 FM. Yeah? 8 FM means sampling interval is very very small. For example, in PCM system, suppose one sample is here and other sample is here and next other sample is here. This is in PCM. In delta modulation, if one sample is here, then other sample is here, and then other sample is here, other sample is here. So these samples are highly correlated. These samples are highly correlated. And you can see here, this is the actual samples, and this is the staircase sample. If the difference between these two, V and TS is the error signal. Error signal, this is equals to X and TS minus this X cap and TS. If this is equals to positive means if the actual signal amplitude is greater than the previous sample, the staircase sample. This is the previous sample. If the difference is positive, now it add plus step size to the previous samples. Previous amplitude of the sample and transmitted bit 1. Yeah? If difference is negative, now it subtract and denoted by bit 0. So by this way, at the modulator output, we will find this is the plus delta or minus delta. If positive, subtraction is positive, now denoted by bit 1. If negative, this is the bit by bit 0. Yeah? So this is the procedure. And one bit modulation, why? Because the difference between the present samples and previous samples is very very small.
That's why used as the one bit quantizer. This is also known as two level staircase quantizer. This is also known as the hard limiter. Right? So from this diagram, we can see that. The error signal here, this is the error signal. Now this ENTS is the error signal. This is equal to actual signal XNTS minus X cap NTS. Here, where X cap NTS is equals to where this is equals to U N minus 1 TS. And this block, basically this block is known as accumulator or accumulation unit. And at this point, this is the output of accumulator. Right? Where accumulator output is the UNTS. This is equals to, I mean this EQNTS plus this quantity. This quantity is U of N minus 1 TS. Here this EQNTS is the quantized one bit quantizer output. Quantization of this is also known as hard limiter. This is also known as hard limiter, and generally it is represented by like this. If difference is positive, it add this step size, and if difference is negative, it is minus this delta. And the total step size is basically this is, suppose this equals to 2 up there, where this then equals to the step half of the step size. Right? How to represent EQNTS? EQNTS where EQNTS is the 1 bit quantizer output. 1 bit quantizer output, this is equals to this delta signum of ENTS. This is delta signum of the error value. Error value. Now this is equals to, this is again equals to now VNTS, or this is equals to VNTS. This is the binary form. This is the binary data. Right? This is the binary data. Now this output, this UNTS, I mean this VNTS equals to this value. Now you can see if the XNTS is greater than X cap NTS, now this is the delta. Now this value is, this is equals to plus delta if XNTS is greater than R equals to X cap NTS, and this is the minus delta if X NTS is less than X cap NTS. Here, if now difference is positive, now it transmit by the bit 1. Bit 1 transmitted. If difference is negative, now it subtract 1 step size, half of step size, now bit 0 is transmitted. Bit 0 is transmitted. So by this way now, every sample is denoted by either bit 0 or bit 1. If difference, now this difference, error signal is positive, now add 1 step, half step size, and denoted by bit 1. If difference is negative, now subtract half step size, and denoted by the bit 0. Right? So by this way now, we can represent continuous time signal into the binary form. Clear? And this delay element, now you can see, if you compare this block diagram,
with the transmitter of DPCM system, only difference is only this block. In DPCM, now this block is the predictor block, which predict the present sample with the past samples. Why? Here use the delay element. Delay element means it provide one unit, one TS unit delay in the previous block. One unit delay means it compare, it approximate with the previous samples, right? And in the working principle, there is no major differences. So this is the procedure, this is the working of the delta modulator or transmitter of the delta modulation, right? So same thing is written in this form. The demodulated circuit of the delta modulation. The demodulated circuit of the delta modulation. Similar to the DPCM system, they are using the predictor element, but in delta modulation, again using the delay element, which provide one TS in one unit delay by the TS. Right? This is the VMTS or the binary data. Binary data and this is the binary data and this is the delay element. And here you will find, if you mathematically analyze, now this demodulated circuit of the delta modulation, we will find this is the accumulator circuit. This is the accumulator circuit and the output of accumulator is, now this is the, I mean this quantity. So from here, U of n minus 1 TS, this is equal to same value, this x time and ts, this is equal to x and ts minus p and ts from the transmitter block. Now this approximated signal equals to actual signal minus error signal. Now this is taken from the error signal, p and ts equals to x and ts minus x square and ts. So from here, x square and ts is x and ts minus e and ts, where e and ts is the error signal. From DPCM, we know that u and ts equals to x and ts plus q and ts. Similarly, we can write here this u of n minus 1 ts equals to x of n minus 1 ts plus q of n minus 1 ts. Right? Hence we can represent, basically substitute this values here. This values here means here, this quantity is equal to this quantity. From here, the error signal. Now we can put here, this is equal to x and ts minus x cap and ts equals to basically u n minus 1 ts. U of n minus 1 ts. Now we know that x and ts minus u n minus 1 ts equals to this quantity. So this is x n minus 1 ts plus q and ts. Clear? So from here, actual signal with the approximate previous samples. This is the actual samples, this is the previous samples. If both are the same, now only difference is the quantization error. Only difference is the quantization error. So by this way, now we can and when we will, this output is providing the low pass filter signal. These are the high frequency signal. Only quantization error is passed the signal, and this is smoothed by the low pass filter, which has the frequency is 3.4 kHz. And at the destination point, we receive the demodulated signal. Right? So this is the procedure to demodulate the delta modulation signal. But there are so many advantages of the delta modulation, and there are some disadvantages of the also delta modulation. There are the slope overload distortion and the granular noise. Yeah? What is the slope overload distortion? Okay. Now this figure, now we can see from this figure, this is the figure. Suppose this is a continuous time signal. When we using the fixed step size, now the envelope of this staircase signal do not follow the envelope of the modulating signal. I mean slope of this signal is not touching the slope of this signal, right? So this kind of, this is now, this shaded area basically represent the slope overload distortion, because slope overload distortion, when you recover the signal, now you cannot get the original signal, because after the recovery it passes on this signal. Now this information may be lost out. How to overcome basically this distortion? To increase the step size. If we increase the step size, for example, suppose step size is, now the slope of this staircase approximation is nearly equal to the slope of this actual signal. From this way now we can minimize or overcome the slope overload distortion. And in other hand, if you are using the fixed step size, for example suppose like this. Now this is, at this cases, when you demodulate this signal, it receives at the straight line. Received at the straight line is while you are transmitting the AC signal of the low variation, but at the receiver side you receive the DC signal. So how to overcome this granular noise? To decrease the step size. If we are decreasing, for example, suppose this is the signal, if we are decreasing the step size like this, and when we demodulate at the demodulator side, we will find the like this signal. So by this way now we can minimize the granular noise. Granular noise is minimized by reducing the step size, while slope overload distortion is reduces by increasing the step size. Clear? Mathematically, how to increase? If the maximum slope of staircase approximation is greater than or equals to maximum value of the d upon dt xt. Yeah, this is the procedure. This is the procedure to minimize the slope overload distortion. Clear? By this way, now you can see here slope of staircase approximation is greater than or equals to the slope of the XT signal. From this situation now we can, how to find the slope of this staircase signal? The slope of staircase signal, basically this is the delta upon TS delta. This must be greater than or equals to the maximum slope of the XT signal. Suppose XT is the, if XT is the AM sine of omega MT, or this is equals to AM sine of 2 pi FMT. When we differentiate this signal, now this is d upon dt XT. Now this is equals to AM 2 pi FMT. Right? So this is equals to AM 2 pi FM T. 2 pi FM. From this, the slope overload distortion is minimized if the amplitude of the modulating signal means this step size must be greater than or equals to AM 2 pi FM upon FS delta. Clear? So minimum step size must be equals to AM 2 pi FM upon FS delta. If this condition is increased, the step size up to AM, AM is the amplitude of the continuous time signal, 2 pi FM upon the FS delta, where FS delta is the sampling frequency for the delta modulation, where this FS delta is at least 3 or 4 times of the FS of the PCM system. Here, other situation, now this amplitude of the modulating signal must be this AM. AM must be less than or equals to delta into FS delta upon 2 pi FM. Means the maximum value of the amplitude of modulating signal must be equals to step size FS delta upon 2 pi FM. Right? And minimum sampling frequency and this FS delta must be less than or equals to AM 2 pi FM upon delta. If these conditions are satisfied, now the slope overload distortion can be minimized. Clear? And the granular noise, how to minimize the granular noise? By reducing the step size, now you can minimize the granular noise. Now, signal to noise ratio of delta modulation is discussed in the next class. Thank you.